All right, we're going to convert expanded form circles to standard form circles. All right, and how we're going to do that is we're going to do number one and number two at the exact same time. It says rearrange the equation and move the constant. All right, so I'm going to break, when I rearrange this, I'm going to break it into its pieces of x and y. So you'll notice there is only one part that is an x, that is x squared. And then I'm going to collect all of my y values. So I'm going to say y squared minus 6y. And then what I'm going to do is move that negative 91 over to the other side. So that is going to become a positive 91 in order to do that. Okay. The second thing we're going to do is we're going to complete the square with x's and y's. Now, the cool thing about the x squared is it is already done. If I was to make a square with x squared, it is just simply x times x, meaning they are exactly the same on both sides. So there's nothing we have to do to complete the square to x squared. However, when we go to the next one, it becomes a little trickier because we do have y squared and we have that negative 6y. And remember, the negative 6y is going to be the sum of the diagonal of the box. So let's go ahead and put this here. I've got y and y making that individual box of y squared. But because it's completing the square, the two spaces here need to be exactly the same because the square has equal length on both sides. All right, so how do I do that? If this is the same as this in those spots, that means these boxes need to be the same. So they're gonna sum by doing half of the value of negative 6. And notice what happens, it becomes y minus 3 and y minus 3, or it becomes y minus 3 times y minus 3, which is y minus 3 squared, okay? And now pay attention, we do have that x squared in there. So we've made a connection to that x squared. Now, we're not quite done with that box value yet. And the reason why is because we now have a new box that can be filled in here. It is negative 3 times negative 3, which is positive 9. Check it out, that is positive 9. And it is being accounted for in this side of the equation, okay? So what we need to do is we need to bring down our original 91. Nothing changed here. This all remained the exact same. So we don't add anything. So I'm gonna just put plus 0, okay? But notice what ended up happening here is we added 9 to this side of the equation. So to keep everything balanced as if we didn't change any of the equation, I'm gonna take this positive 9 that went into this y minus 3 squared, and I'm also going to add it to the other side, plus 9, okay? That keeps one side equal to the other and balanced, okay? So we rewrite our equation, x squared plus y minus 3 squared equals to 91 plus 0 plus 9, which is 100, okay? Now, what is the center? The center is 0, positive 3. Remember, we use the opposite of the minus 3, and there's nothing being added to the x. And then what is the radius? The radius is the square root of 100, which is simply 10.